Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Anand Kumar Sharma. I'm rank 62 in CSE 2018. In this video, we'll be talking about how to read economic survey and get maximum output from that, so that you are able to utilize it in your answers or on your prelims. Economic survey has two volumes, volume 1 and volume 2. And both the volumes have different utilities and has to be read in different manner. And it is useful in both for prelims also and mains also. For prelims, questions can come directly from it, like the statements, and you have to see which statement is true or false. For mains, the utility is very much there for GS 1, 2, 3 as well as for the essay, because it gives you lot of data, figures, diagrams and also the comparative analysis of many aspects of the Indian economy. So we'll first start with the volume 1, that how it can be useful. So volume 1 is generally deals with the various issues which are there in the Indian economy, especially the area wise. Like for example, sometimes they give about the fertilizer sector, or sometime with the agriculture sector, like they have this time given about the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan or the judiciary or on the MSME sector. So in that way, what you can do is first have a simple reading of the economic survey. Just go through it so that you have a basic idea that what are the issues which are they have dealt with it. And then there can be two approach. Either you make your notes from the economic survey, or there are summaries available in the market. From the summary, you can focus on topic wise. You can add on your answer. For example, there's a question on there's a topic on MSME. So wherever you are reading MSME, you can write down the points given there, or you can write down what are the extra topics given there. Generally, on each topics, what exactly they deal with is the problem statement, what is the problem facing in those areas or those sectors, then some data or comparative analysis of that, or with graphs and pie charts or maybe bar columns, and further then the solution. So your focus should be mainly on the problem statement and the solutions, that what are the solutions they are providing and what are the problem they have identified. Many of the problem might be, you might also be knowing, but there might be one or two problem which is new to you. So add that thing in your notes. Similarly, solution. Many of the solutions are very unique, and especially some of them which the government have planned or are the in the pipeline of the government. So that will add value to your answer. You may directly quote in your answer also ki as per economic survey, or you may directly write as a solution also. Like for example, in 1 year back in economic survey, they have mentioned about the fertilizer subsidy. So they mentioned about the solutions also, that these solutions can be done about the fertilizer so that you can utilize them. So similarly, in this manner, section wise you prepare it, that what are the sectors they are dealing with, and then write your notes and give problem statement and solution. Plus you can find some data or good map or paragraph or any by pie chart or bar column or any graphical analysis they have given, but do not give much focus on them, because many of them are not of our purpose, for that is for their own purpose, like comparative analysis of states, that is not needed for your purpose. So you can ignore that part. Similarly, there are datas given. Like so, for example, there's a topic on Swachh Bharat Mission. Now they have mentioned that this much of population was not having the toilets in our country. 50% of the population does not have a toilet cover before Swachh Bharat Mission. Now 99.2% have the toilet cover. That is the data you have given. So this data you can utilize in your answers, for maybe for GS or maybe for SA. So for maintain one separate copy and add that data. Write that data separately, that these are the useful data. There might be 40-50 data which might be useful for you. So that will be helping in. So this way the volume 1 can be useful to you, sector wise analysis or the area wise analysis they might be giving on topics of health, education, judiciary, economy, polity, whatever, many of the things they have covered in their parts. So this way you can use economic survey for the qualitative improvement of your answers. The volume 2 is much more a data collection or the compilation of the various performances of various sectors or the government investments as well as. So volume 2, what you can do is do one thing, like they have mentioned about the various sectors, the improvement of the services, manufacturing, external sector, or these ways. So in this manner, what you can do is just maintain one page for each sector and write about their performances. What the government, what they do is they tell about the performance, whether they are performing good or bad, that you can write in the data analysis or with the help of a graph. Along with that, what schemes government have done or are they planning to do, they also mention about them. For example, if they mention about power, they will mention about the schemes of the power sector. In that manner, you can write all the schemes. So you will have a collection of all the government efforts, the government schemes or government initiative in various sector along with data analysis. So focus on volume 1 should be more, and 2 should be a study which you should do only on the basis of data and the schemes, not a very much detailed study for most of the topics in the volume 2. Volume 1 is much more crucial, which will add quality to your answers. Volume 2 is much more on the data collection or compilation for government purposes. So that has to be studied very selectively, and you can choose data only and as well as the government schemes in those sectors, so that you can utilize them in while you are writing. Sometimes directly questions comes in these sectors, what are the government initiative that has been done? So that will be easily available to you in the economic survey, and you don't have to go around here and there to collect the schemes or the programs done by the government on those sectors. Along with that, what you can do is, like for the data collection, there are some good model examples. The boxes in the economic survey, they generally give the good solutions or good case studies or good model examples across the country or across the world. So you can note down those good example, good models or good solutions provided there, because they are something which the government is planning to do, or they can be replicated along where for those sectors or for those areas. So focus on the boxes should be there, because boxes have a very good information available for you for your quality enrichment of your answers. So in this manner, first give a reading of volume 1 and upper overview of volume 2, and then later on either you can write your own notes or follow a summary with a systematic approach, as I told you in this video. In this manner, you can utilize economic survey for the qualitative improvement of your answers in GS 1, 2, 3 as well as in the essay, as well as improve your understanding of the basic issues of economy. Further, we'll be dealing with the chapters of the economic survey in the further lectures. Thank you.
Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get latest updates on upcoming videos.